The mercy of Naam Prabhu, first anarth nivritti would take place and then one will realize the Savrupa. Naam is called sadhana as well as sadhya. There is no difference between Naam and Nami. Still, Naam is more glorified in scriptures. So in the Shastra it is said to chant the Nama Mantra. Just like Srimad Mahaprabhu asked question to Savrup Damodar and Raya Ramananda. That everyone chants Nam, but how? By chanting the Nam, the love would get manifested in the heart. What is our aim? Prem Prayojan. Krishna Sambandha is Bhakti Abhidhyaya and Prem Prayojan. So Bhakti is Abhidhyaya and Prem is Prayojan. Then how to achieve that Prem? So with this context, the sadhana bhakti, bhava bhakti and prema bhakti has been explained in the Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu, Srila Rupa Goswami Pada. He has explained it elaborately about this sadhana bhava and prema bhakti. Bhakti Vinod Thakur in this granth Specifically, he is concentrating on Naam. Because in the Kali Yuga, there is no other dharma except the Harinam. And all the scriptures' essence is to chant Harinam. So we are hearing the glories of Harinam. The Bhakti Vinod Thakur, very beautifully, he is telling about the Yugala Naam. It's 16 names and 32 alphabets. So we have heard about this Harinam, Jat Rati Sadhak and Ajat Rati Sadhak, that how both will be chanting the Harinam. So one should pay attention to the Harinam, that it is meeting separation, meeting separation. So one should also meditate upon Naam Mantra. At the time of japa, so leaving all things except Krishna, one should only concentrate on Harinam, Smaran and Kirtan of the Harinam only, and not having any attention towards other things except Harinam. Bhakti Vinod Thakur, by this Bangla Payar, he is explaining that a sadhak every day, for some time at a lonely place, he should sit and chant Harinam. So one should chant Harinam sitting alone for some time every day. And also always in the association of the sadhus, he should try to control his senses. But the senses of a conditioned souls, 5 karmendriya and 5 gyanendriya, they always keep on moving towards 5 ras. This is their natural tendency, that they go towards 5 tanmatra, rupa, rasa, shabda, sparsha, gandha. So that is why it is said that with a concentrated mind at a lonely place, he should chant Nama Mantra. But always chanting the Naam and also thinking about the Leela. For a Baddha Jeeva, his mind keeps on wandering here and there. So he should try to control his heart, his mind, from going here and there. For a conditioned soul, for a Mukta Jeeva, liberated soul, wherever they live, naturally their mind is attracted towards Krishna. But for a conditioned soul, his mind is always attracted towards Vishaya Katha, sense objects. So we keep on asking questions to others, but here in this shloka, the question is asked to the mind, that in all the Vedas, Puran, Upanishad, Harinam is glorified so much. So that Harinam is so sweet, why you do not have any interest in chanting that beautiful sweet Harinam? So first one should ask the question to the mind that why don't you have the interest in chanting Harinam? Have you ever asked your mind? No. So we lose control on our mind, just like the horse. When the horse is uncontrolled, then the horse runs away. So the mind is just like the horse, which should be controlled always. Then what is the answer? So this is a bhajan, I think, written by Bhaktivinoda Thakur, that what is the answer, that why we do not have the interest in the Harinam? Just like when we feel hunger, whatever, what kind of, like any kind of food would come in front of us, if we are hungry, we will surely eat it. But if we are not hungry, and those whose digestion power is very less, they never feel hunger. Even if for him, if you present so many nice food items, he would not have any interest in eating. So he will first ask the question, what food items are there, whether there is a salt in it or not. So he will only accept a little bit of those food items because he doesn't have any hunger or interest. But when one has a great hunger and he is feeling so hungry, you get any kind of food, you will not be specific about the food, and with great love and respect you will eat it. So here also the question to the mind is that why don't you have the interest in the chanting? The answer is that in the previous life you have been engaged in the papa karma, in the sinful activities. So in the last birth, in the previous birth, I have done so many sinful activities. That is why I do not have any interest. And I have more interest in the karma jnana. My mind goes into other things, but not into chanting Harinam, not into hearing Harikatha. There is one story of the Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Goswami Prabhupada's life. Once Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Goswami Prabhupada, he was collecting some money for the Mayapur temple and he was going to Calcutta for some collection. He saw a very big building. He knocked the door of the manager of the building. So he came out and said, what is it that I have come to meet manager? Then those people said to the manager that one Sant Mahatma has come to meet you. Manager said, I am busy right now. I do not have time. What money he wants, 200 rupees, 300 rupees, give it to him. But I cannot meet him. So many rich people, for many years I was in Mathura and I did bhiksha for the temple service. I know the behaviors of these rich people. So Prabhupada said, no, I want to meet with manager. Manager said, I do not have time to meet you. He has so many phones and he is so busy in calling and is busy in export, import, so he doesn't have any time. Prabhupada left that place. So he went, so it's been 20-25 years now. One day, Prabhupada, he was going nearby the same building and he saw that there is a person on the street. He is selling some towels, some gamcha. And his specs is very big, having dirt on it. And the sticks are broken, so he is using the thread to bind the specs. So Prabhupada asked that I came to meet a manager 25 years back, but today I see that this building is in a very bad condition. Where is that manager of the building? I came 25 years back here to meet with that manager, but he did not meet me. So that person who was selling, he started crying. He said, Maharaj, I am the same manager. My all business got failed. So whatever export import I used to do from the countries, but now I lost my all business. Just like the corona is going on, many businessmen have lost their businesses. So I am the same manager. Now I have time, so you please sit here. So this world's situation is just like that manager. People going in the karma marg, jnana marg, the people becomes just like that manager. They do not have time to sit near a sadhu. The reason is only one, that they have very less sukritis, or they do not have any sukritis. Bhakti utha sukritis they do not have. So if you do not have the bhakti sukritis, you will never get interest in Bhagavad Naam, Bhagavad Katha. So in this song, it is said that because of the previous sinful activities, there is no interest of the mind to chant Harinam. In this Bangla Kirtan it is said, if there is a Krishna Katha, you get pain in your head, just like there is a thunder bolt struck on your head. So if there is Krishna Katha, you feel like thunder bolt on your head. If the Krishna Katha has started, you will feel headache. You will seek for a pillow to sleep, to take rest. And if there is Asat Katha, and if there is a Katha except Krishna Katha, then your interest increases. For the Gramya Katha, for the materialistic talks, your eyes will open, it will become big, wide open. Even if you have come from the office, you are so tired, but you have seen that in the neighbor something wrong has happened and some people are discussing, and then you will forget all your tiredness. If there is some cricket going in Australia, and for the whole night the people keep on watching the TV, the cricket match, and even they do not pay attention that how much time has been passed. So many people think that I will watch the TV for 2 minutes, but they keep on watching for hours. But if there is Bhagavad Katha, Bhagavad Naam, they feel headache. It is very, very difficult to have interest in Bhagavad Katha. So here it is also said, that a Baddha Jeev should always be in the association of the Sadhu. And mind should be engaged in the Bhagavad Katha. Even he does not have any interest, but still he should engage his mind in the Bhagavad Katha and Bhagavad Nama Japa. So our heart should be clean. One is internal, one is external. Both should be pure. Antare bahire sama vyavahar. That outside and inside one should be pure. And what does the silence mean? That except the Krishna Katha one should not speak anything else. Wherever the two people sit together, first they do Harinam for few minutes and then they start talking the materialistic things, Vishaya Katha. Now, a day is, if two people sit together, there is only Corona Katha. It's been 3 months this Corona is going on. Naam is very beautiful, Corona. So, no, one should not discuss these things, only Bhagavad Katha Chintan. That at the time of mantra japa one should not talk anything materialistic. And one should always chant with tolerance, that while chanting the Harinam one should try to control his mind. And one should never leave the tolerance, that with the time one should have this firm belief that with the time I will surely achieve it. Utsahat nischayat dhairyat tat tat karma parvartanat. So one should always have this encouragement, this utsaha in the Bhagavad Seva, Bhagavad Japa. Always mind should be engaged in the service, because our mind is just like a ghost. Gurudev used to give an example. One disciple said to Gurudev, that give me a mantra to control the ghost. Guru said, why you want this kind of mantra? But disciple insisted. Gurudev gave the mantra to the disciple how to control a ghost. And as soon as he was chanting this mantra, the bhoot came and the bhoot said, give me the work, give me some activity. And whatever activity was given to that ghost, and he can complete it very soon, and again he would come and give me some work, otherwise I will eat you. So how much work he was giving, he was doing it right away and asking again and again. So he was in such a trouble, and he went to his Gurudev that what can I do now? What should I do now? Gurudev said, I asked you earlier not to have this mantra. Then he prayed to the Gurudev, please protect me from this ghost. My Gurudev Vamana Swami Maharaj sometimes, he used to speak many stories of the ghost. He himself used to say that I have liberated so many ghosts. Gurudev used to say that even I made the ghost married with each other, and the people used to laugh. But Mahabhagavat, whatever they say, is a truth. My Gurudev was Mahabhagavat. You know the history. This Manohar Babaji Maharaj, and in the Gopinath Math, that fat person Parishananda, if you ask him that this is not a lie, because both are present in front of us, Manohar Baba and Parishananda Prabhu is also present, and Parameshwari Prabhu is also present. So all three are present as a proof. So this is not a useless talk, because when one get the Charanamrita of a Mahabhagavat, even the great, great ghost can be liberated. You ask Parameshwari Prabhu, you ask Manohar Baba, they know this story, that ghost himself said that Srila Vaman Goswami Maharaj came in this mutt in that year, and your and his Charanamrita is present in one room with Manohar Baba. So you give me that Charanamrita and I will be liberated. So this is a truth. So they are not, he was not ordinary. So this story is not about joking, it is a truth. My Gurudev was not an ordinary person. So that is why Guru Maharaj used to speak the stories of the ghost, how many ghosts he has delivered. By hearing this story, your hairs stand till end, and some people cannot sleep in the night because of the fear of the ghost. Gaur, kaangi ab chota, kuch border lagta hai. Wo bata.
Wo koi sant mahatma hai, tum usko bhoot soch rahe ho. Tum bhoot soch rahe ho.
You are thinking him to be ghost. Because you are ghost and you are looking at others as ghost. They are not ghost, they are Santa Mahatma. If they are in the mandir, some ghost is doing parikrama of the mandir and you have seen it, then he is not a ghost, he is a saint. That in this Vrindavan I have heard that Ashwatthama is also present in Vrindavan. And he also gives darshan to someone. He has a big body. So many people call him the ghost, but the one who knows him, that he is Ashwatthama. Wherever there is Bhagavat Katha, Bhagavat Nama Jap, and the Sant Mahatma, those who have come here, their lotus feet dust is present, how can the ghost be there in the temple? There is no ghost here. So he must be a Sant Mahatma. He is doing bhajan in the temple, in that body. Because it is not required that one needs a human body to do bhajan. So he has not got his siddhi, so he is doing his bhajan, maybe in the ghost body. And you are thinking him to be ghost and scared of him. Never be scared of anyone. So you should offer pranam to that ghost if you see anyone. Actually, God is always scared of the ghost. So Maharaj says that never be scared of the ghost. Offer pranam and he will give you blessings. So there can be no ghost in the temple. Because otherwise the words of the Shastra will be nullified, because wherever it is written that wherever there is a bell of the temple being rang, so there no ghost can exist. Srila Vaman Goswami Maharaj, Srila Trivikram Goswami Maharaj, Srila Gurudev has done bhajan in the temple. The great, great saints have arrived here. How can a ghost live here? How can the ghost be in the temple? So it is just our mind's imagination only. What is the meaning of the word bhoot? Bhoot means that is a past. Bhoot word has many meanings. And maybe if I believe in your sayings that there is a ghost in the temple, just like the Gokarn has delivered his brother Dhandukari. So here, many times the Bhagavat Saptah has taken place. Tirtha Maharaj has done the Bhagavat many times here. So how can the ghost would be here? So it is only your mind's imagination. So there is no ghost. If you have seen anyone, it must be a saint. He is doing bhajan in that body. He might be doing the parikrama of the Thakur Ji to complete his bhajan. He is doing nama bhajan. And you are also so fortunate that he has given darshan to you. And I offer pranam to you that you have seen that great saint, and I have not seen him. Because there cannot be any ghost. So if you have seen any ghost, it is very good. Because he is a saint, and looking at a saint is very auspicious. My Gurudev used to speak these kind of stories. Should I tell you one story? My Gurudev, once he was doing preaching in Assam, Srila Vaman Goswami Maharaj. Is there anyone else who is the disciple of Srila Vaman Goswami Maharaj? So our Gurudev used to say when he went on the preaching in Assam, I have not gone to Assam, the houses in the Assam, in the Meghalaya, in the Assam, in the northeast. So the devotees, they gave a place to stay for the Gurudev, and Gurudev used to go from one house to another house, and the houses were far away for preaching 50 years back. And there was also the forest in between when they used to go from one house to another house. Gurudev went to that room. He was a rich person in whose house the Gurudev was staying. So that he was having two houses, so he gave one house to Gurudev and all the servants of the Gurudev. And in the another house, it was not very much away, it was like 50-60 meters only. So the another house he was staying. The servants of the Gurudev started preparing the food, and one person knocked the door of the Gurudev and said, Gurudev was so merciful that if anyone would call him, that he will go anywhere without his servants. So that person said that my son is very sick, that you bless him. Gurudev did not call any of his servants, and he went with that person. There was a vehicle, the horse vehicle, they sat on that vehicle, and they went very far away, and there was a forest on the way, and there was a building, and on the second floor of that building, गुरुदेव saw that that person when he goes from the first to the second floor he goes fastly.
Gurudev
started thinking that it means there is a ghost here, that is why he is scared. Gurudev saw two things, that sometimes that person he keeps 1 foot down and 1 foot on the second floor and he can jump on the second floor. Gurudev was surprised to see that he is a ghost. Now will you be able to sleep in the night or not? So that person who called Gurudev, he was a ghost. So he kept his 1 foot on the first floor and the second foot on the second floor. And he was moving very fast. And he was having a garland and offered to the Gurudev. And that flower which was not seasonal, so that flower's garland he offered to Gurudev.
So,
Gurudev then observed that when he used to go up on the stairs, his feet were in the opposite direction. This is what Gurudev used to tell, that because I have not seen the ghost, their feet are in the opposite direction. That they move like forward way, their feet are in the backward position. I have not seen any ghost, this is what Gurudev used to say. Gurudev did not get scared. If we would have been there, we got scared. Then they went on the second floor and he saw that there is a boy lying on a bed and there is a white cloth over it covering him. Gurudev gave him blessings doing Swasti Vachan. So Gurudev blessed him. Then I saw, Gurudev said that as soon as I gave blessings to him, that bed was empty. There was no one on the bed. Then that person said, let's go. That vehicle on which they came, that vehicle was full of so many fruits. From where he got so many fruits and very soon, so Gurudev, he saw that very big watermelon and other fruits were there. And all the fruits which are not seasonal, even those fruits were also present in the cart. And then he dropped me back to the room and he dropped all the fruits, and when I again went out of my room and I saw that there is no horse, there is no cart, there is no person. So in the meantime, then the owner of the house came and he said that where have you gone? And we were all in tension that where were you? Gurudev said that this kind of one person came and his son was sick and I went with him and gave him blessings, and Gurudev told whole story. Then he said, you never go alone, because he was a ghost. In the Assam there are many ghosts in that area. So that ghost, he got liberated. So there are many stories. Our Gurudev, whenever Gurudev used to go to Siliguri, and we were like small people at that time, and Gurudev, we used to sit around Gurudev, and Gurudev used to speak the Gita shlokas and ask Gita shlokas. Gurudev used to test us on the Gita. Because Gita can clarify all your doubts. So Gurudev used to ask so many questions from Gita. And then Gurudev also used to speak the ghost stories amid of asking the questions. And all the brahmacharis in the Navadvip Math, I remember, we were like 50-60 brahmacharis. And all used to get collected at one place when Gurudev used to speak the ghost stories. All the brahmacharis would be present. Gurudev used to live on the ground floor at that time. Now his room is on the second floor. So we used to sit surrounding Gurudev, and Gurudev used to speak these stories of the ghost when he used to come from the Siliguri preaching. Because everyone doesn't have the interest in hearing the shlokas of Gita. So to increase the interest of the brahmacharis, the Gurudev used to speak these kind of stories. So that disciple, he said that this ghost is creating trouble to me, then what should I do now? Then Gurudev said that call your ghost and tell him that there is a big bamboo stick of 16 feet high, and smear the oil on it, like apply the oil on the whole bamboo stick, or ghee, apply the ghee on it. And then you ask that ghost that you go up and down again and again on that bamboo stick, which is having the ghee on it. Whenever I would need you, I will call you. Then that ghost, he kept on going up, then down, up, down, because when there is ghee applied on the bamboo stick, the ghost could not move up. So he was, again, because it was slippery. So our mind is also like that ghost. And if you engage him some activity, then it is fine. Him in the service. It is not very easy to have interest in chanting Harinam 64 rounds. Very, very difficult to chant 64 rounds. And 16 rounds. So you engage your mind in the service. And when you will be having a lot of bhakti mula sukriti, then you will surely get interest in chanting Harinam. Never criticize anyone else. Guru seva, Bhagavat seva, Vaishnav seva, one should do. And chanting. So a sadhaka at the time of mantra japa, he should remember the meeting and the separation past times. And also he should follow five types of rules. What are the five types of rules while chanting? First is mantrartha chintanam, that one should think about the nama mantra. That at the time of chanting, what is the meaning of the naam? One should always think, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. The ordinary meaning is the Radhe Sham, Radhe Sham, Sham Sham, Radhe Radhe. So 16 names and 32 alphabets. Hare Krishna means, Hare means Radhe, He Radhe. What is the main name of Radhika is Hara. हरेति कृष्ण मन इति हरा द वन हु विद हर नाम रूप गुण लीला अट्रैक्ट्स द हार्ट ऑफ कृष्णा दैट इज कॉल्ड हरा एंड इन द संबोधन पद व्हाइल कॉलिंग आउट वी कॉल इट हरे and Krishna, kri means to attract attraction. The one who attracts all the jivas towards himself is called Krishna. And also giving renunciation from all type of bhoga and giving ananda to that jiva. Kanishtha adhikari, madhyam adhikari, uttam adhikari, one has to practice. That is why Bhaktivinoda Thakur is saying at the time of sadhan, if you are not considering the meanings of the naam, then how can you achieve siddhi? So at the time of sadhan, naam sadhan, one should always think about the meanings of the mantra, nama artha chintanam. So if a sadhak is not thinking about the meanings, then how can he achieve the siddhi? So at the time of chanting, one should always think about the meanings of the Harinam. So there are many further stages, but at least the first stage is that at the time of Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, one should remember the meanings. So automatically you will be able to remember the meanings. Maybe in the very starting, in the beginning, it will be difficult for you to remember the meanings of the mantra. But one has to practice, that one should remember the meanings of the mantras. Namartha Chintanam, this is the first thing. There is not much difference between Naam and Mantra. What is Naam? Naam is Sambodhanatmak. If someone is far away, then how will you call him? You use the word He. So in the Naam, this is called Sambodhan Pad, means you are calling out someone. And Mantra has Namaha Swaha, that it is offering, in the offering sense, that you are offering it. It is called Sampradan Karak, offering. That we are offering ourselves while we are chanting the mantra, Namaha Swaha. So in the last of the mantra is always Namaha or Swaha. Swaha. Namaha. So one has to think about all these meanings. If you are not thinking about these meanings in the sadhan kal, then how can you achieve siddhi? So Bhaktivinoda Thakur is writing, I am not saying it. Just like the raw mango and the ripened mango. The raw mango is called as ami, it is called ami, and you cannot eat it directly. And if you eat it, then you will get the cuts, wounds, or in your lips or in your mouth. So it will be sour in taste, but when it will be ripened, it is sweet. So in the sadhana and the siddhi, there is only a thought of pakva, apakva, raw and ripened. you have heard that what is sadhak, what is siddha, what is sadhan bhakti, bhava bhakti, prema bhakti. So you have got this tattva gyan, but why tattva gyan one cannot achieve? One has to do bhajan sadhan. साधने करीबे जहाँ सिद्धि ते पाई बेतार केवल मात्र पक्व अपक्व विचार दैट एट द टाइम ऑफ डूइंग साधन वट एवर यू आर थिंकिंग अबाउट द हरि नाम दैट विल बी राइपन्ड स्लोली स्लोली एंड इट विल गिव यू सिद्धि सो एट द टाइम ऑफ साधन स्लोली स्लोली वन शुड ऑलवेज रिमेंबर अबाउट द मीनिंग्स ऑफ द हरि नाम In the Bhaktivinoda Thakur, that is why in the first chapter, Gurudev, that for the 3-4 months, Gurudev continuously, he was doing part on this first chapter. Many times Gurudev has done pravachan on this first chapter. For the first time when he started this Bhajan Rahasya, I remember that the first chapter I used to write everything. Whatever Gurudev used to speak, I used to write it. Everything is present in the Mathura. All my writings are present. So this is called Nama Artha Chintanam, that the thinking about the meaning of the Hari Nam. So whatever quantity of the Nam you are doing, whatever rounds you are doing, but you should do it perfectly by doing the Chintan, remembering the meanings. And second is Mantra Adhi Devata. According to the instructions of the Gurudev, how to chant, what is the process of chanting, that how to move the finger at the time of Diksha, one gets these instructions, that starting from here and moving in this direction. So Gurudev tells this movement of the fingers. So it is not as per your mind, it is about as per the instructions of the Gurudev. The way the Gurudev has explained to you. You can do extra rounds of the Harinam, it is your property, you can chant, but the Guru Pradatta Mantra, whatever instructions the Gurudev has given, so one has to follow, whether it is to be 8 times, 10 times or 12 times, so one has to follow that instruction of the Gurudev. One should not increase that mantra's of rounds. Then is prapatti. Prapatti is having shelter to the lotus feet of the mantra devata. So one should think that I am so suffering in this world. Akula prana. Pave Nanaji Sandhan. So this is the kirtan of the Bhakti Vinod Thakur, that in this materialistic ocean I have fallen, and I have fallen in this materialistic ocean. O Prabhu, that you deliver me from this materialistic ocean. One should have these kind of prayers. This is called Sharanagati. And after Sharanagati, the fifth is Atmanivedan. That whatever I have is belongs to you. Even my body and the things related to the body are not mine. It is yours. Atmanivedan tu apade kari. So last is the Atmanivedan. So this is the process of chanting. So if we are not following this process, we cannot progress. If we are not doing the bhajan sadhan properly, then how can we progress? And you will go, if you are not following the process in the right way, and very soon you will be 60 years of age and you are leading towards your death. When you will be doing the proper bhajan? The time has arrived that how my mind would be situated in your lotus feet. In the bhajan rahasya, this is a very beautiful granth. I do not want to move very fast in the granth, just like the Gurudev used to speak very slowly. That is why I'm doing this granth very slowly. In the morning also the bhajan rahasya is going on, and I think it's sixth chapter is going on, but the bhajan rahasya is such a great scripture. One should always read it, study it very slowly, because this is the right process which is explained, that how to do bhajan. So our Gurudev used to say, in the sadhan kal, at the time of doing sadhan, so in the proportion it would be of good quality, and in the same proportion you will be achieving your perfection. And then with the mercy of the Nama Prabhu, you will get all these things manifested. But even if following this process, your mind is still not getting attracted towards the Nama Jap, then there are five type of processes that I will explain tomorrow. So there are further five type of rules if you still doesn't get any interest in chanting, that I will explain tomorrow.